full-fledged gameplay video. Oh yes. It's time to don your sword and sandals. It's a time for big biceps and even bigger tits. The Witcher 2 on the Xbox 360 still looks good. Still looks like a good game. I can quite easily go on and play games from this generation with no issues at all. I don't get hung up with frame rates and all that kind of malarkey. And I am enjoying this. I don't like to say that. I really don't. Simply because this is not really my genre. If I'm going to be honest, and I want to be honest with you guys, but I'm enjoying it. I really am. Okay, let's rob some orans or whatever they're called from there. Okay, talk to Philippa at her home. Magic artifact 0. So can we go through here? Yes, playing this at the moment. Playing it. I will finish it. I will complete it. You know how it goes on this channel. I don't think she's in there. So how far have I got? Can we have a look? I don't think you can see the stats. Yeah, I don't think there's anywhere you can view the stats, if I'm honest. But I shall show you the character skill tree. So that's kind of how far I am at the moment. So it's early days, it's early days. I don't think, I don't know. 10 hours if I'm lucky. Maybe not even that. But as I say, I'm really enjoying it. The story is complex, so I've managed to keep track of that. Initially, I was kind of really daunted by the whole RPG element, and I seem to have overcome that because it's been years since I've really taken an RPG seriously, to be honest with you. Can we go in there or not?
Don't let her die, Vatican.
You gonna let me in there? Can I sneak past? Let me in! Come on! Brexit! Come on! Yeah, this little town is very difficult to negotiate. It really is. I haven't really got a clue how to get around there. Well, let's just go through one of those doors. Yeah, I really do like it. What can I say? It's my current proper game at the moment. The one I'm playing at the moment. I like all the characters, and there's some quite, I'm quite surprised, there's some quite laugh out loud moments with the script and everything else. What if we pop in here? Let's pop in here and just rob someone casually, I suppose. Aha, you can get through here. Ah, now this is making sense. So where's Philippa? Right, looks like we found the right place, folks. Oh, hang on. Oh, yeah. Oi, oi, Savonoi.
What is it, Witcher?
Who was that girl?
Cynthia, a leashed sorceress.
A charming expression. Do you also use muzzles?
Leash means a connection between a sorceress and her assistant.
Oh, yeah.
An unfortunate term, I admit, but it explains how things are. Cynthia can tap my power, use my spells. She's a conduit. And she's learning along the way. It's convenient, and except for the name, not derisive at all. But you're not here to talk about Cynthia.
Oh, great definition. Doesn't really do it for me, girl on girl, to be honest with you. I don't know what all the fuss is about, really. Okay. Let's find out what she's up to.
How is it that King Radovid's court sorceress and advisor is supporting rebellion in Edirne?
This has grown into more than a simple rebellion, Witcher. Prince Stennis's arrival here confirmed Saskia's right to represent Edirne.
Saskia isn't fighting for Edirne, but for the Pontar Valley. Even Prince Stennis considers you rebels. He hasn't moved against you because war with Kedwin hangs by a thread.
Yeah.
Why are you here, Sorceress of Tredegore?
It is my duty. If Henselt occupies the Pontar Valley, Redania and Temeria will respond strongly. The North will disintegrate, its unity gone. A dark scenario that is nevertheless avoidable, provided Saskia is successful and wins the Valley's independence.
Even if she thwarts Henselt, there'll be no independence without agreement from Redania and Temeria.
Temeria's expansionist plans melted away with Foltest's death. Redania's ruler is unpredictable, but even he'll have to respect a victory. I'm here to make this victory a fact.
That's told you. Have you noticed that I'm rocking the elvish armour? It's got slightly better stats. But yeah, I'm going to leave it there. I thought we'd share that one for a few moments. Really enjoying it. As I said, I never thought I'd say that, bring myself to say that. And I don't like to do a video and capture stuff when it's kind of virgin territory. Does that make sense? First time I'm playing something, the story unfolds, you know. I don't want to be capturing it when I'm doing that. So yeah. fingers crossed, my Xbox 360 still hanging in there. I really should pick up a new one. I know you can't get a new one, but a good one, if that makes sense. The last slim variant would do me. It really would, because I'm absolutely petrified that my 360 will give up, which it will do eventually. It has to. But unfortunately, not everything is backwards compatible yet on Xbox One, which is a shame. But they're getting there. They're really getting there. So, yeah. The Witcher 2. Yes, I shall definitely be picking up number 3 on the Xbox One. And yeah. I'm off. Bye-bye.